Hey guys, welcome back to a new video by Biology with Zhang Shen. So today we are going to do the Cambridge IGCSE Biology Paper 4 Theory Extended for the examination from 2023 specimen paper. So if there are any questions, please do comment down in the comment section below and I will try to rectify it as soon as possible. So let's start off with the first question. Question 1A. Figure 1.1 is a photomicrograph showing a surface view of many villi in the small intestine. So you can see there's a lot of villi in here. So part 1, state the function of villi. So basically, it's just a simple function about the role of how the villi works is by absorbing the nutrients into the blood. Part 2, describe the structure of a villus. So for this question, they give you so many lines, but actually the most simplest thing is just to state what is inside of a villus. So the villus will contain the lacteal, the capillaries, and the epithelium containing goblet cells. Just as this simple and you will get your 3 marks. B, part 1, blood transport nutrients. State the component of the blood that transport nutrients. Plasma. Plasma contains a lot of water inside, so this helps with the transport of these nutrients, the red blood cell, to different parts of the body. Part 2. The nutrients in the blood can be used to become part of the cell. State the name of this process, which is assimilation. Part 3. Amino acids are used to make proteins. State 2 examples of proteins that are found in the blood, which is antibodies, insulin. There are a lot of things actually, like glucagon. These are all acceptable. There could be fibrinogen, hemoglobin. Okay, these are all acceptable. C. Explain the effect of cholera bacteria on the digestive system. So ever if you see this kind of question, do remember the structure of how this is written. So the cholera bacteria will first produce the toxin, and the toxin will cause the secretion of chloride ions to the small intestine. So this will cause the water potential in the small intestine to be lowered by osmosis, which results in diarrhea. Okay. Question 2. Insulin is a hormone that regulates the concentration of glucose in the blood. A. Describe what is meant by the term hormone. So this is a very hefty definition mark, and I would like you guys to memorize this. Hormone is a chemical substance produced by the glands, which is carried in the blood to alter the activity of a specific target organ. That is it. Okay, so you can write something similar, but it has to be the same meaning. So if there's no same meaning in this definition you have written, then it will be 0 marks. Okay, B. Person A and person B were monitored to see how well they could control their blood glucose concentration. They did not eat or drink anything other than the water for 8 hours before the monitoring began. They then drank a glucose solution. Blood samples were taken at 30 minutes intervals. The blood samples were tested for glucose concentration and the results are shown in figure 2.1. So they give you two different kind of lines for person A and person B, and there's a trend that you have to explore. Part 1. Calculate the percentage increase in the blood glucose concentration in person A between 60 and 90 minutes and give your answer to the nearest whole number. So the percentage increase is just the basic formula, which is final minus initial over initial times by 100. So for this case, get your values from 60 to 90 minutes in person A definitely, and you will get 170 minus 72 over 72 times 100. You get 136.111, and they want it to be in the nearest whole number, which is 136%. Part 2. Using figure 2.1, compare the response of person A with the response of person B after the ingestion of glucose. So you have to use the figure in 2.1 shown and make comparisons. So there is a similar response between person A and B at the first 30 minutes. Then both increases faster to a higher concentration for person A. Person B will reach the peak much earlier than person A. Sorry, this should be A. After that, both will decrease gradually. Okay, part 3. Using figure 2.1, explain the response of person B after 90 minutes. For this question, is to compare. And now it's asking you to explain Why does this happen? So this happened because there's an increase in glucose concentration, which will signal the insulin to be produced and secreted by the pancreas. The insulin will help to take in glucose into the blood, then converts the glucose into glycogen. Okay. Part 4. Person A had type 1 diabetes. So outline the treatment for type 1 diabetes. Just a very simple one. Just remember this, that type diabetes is about sugar levels. So it could be by insulin injection and controlling carbohydrate or sugar diets, monitoring of the blood glucose concentration, exercise regularly, maintaining a healthy mass, and make sure that insulin cannot be taken by oral treatment, means cannot go through by mouth. Question 3. Figure 3.1 shows a photomicrograph of a human blood. So you can see there are red blood cells, phagocytes, and lymphocytes. So A. Describe the differences in appearance and the function of three cells labeled in figure 3.1. So for this question, I've just written in point form rather than writing a whole paragraph because it'd be very long. But in exam, you must write this in a complete sentence. So for this question, I just pinpoint that red blood cells have a biconcave shape. They are smaller than the white blood cells and its function is only able to transport oxygen. So they want appearance and the function. And phagocytes, it has an irregular shape and it undergoes phagocytosis. Lymphocytes, it has a big nucleus that fills the cell and it helps to produce antibodies. B. Figure 3.2 shows some of the stages of blood clotting. So complete the figure 3.2 by filling in the two empty boxes. So once platelets are collected, what happens is fibrinogen will be converted into fibrin, then it forms a mesh at the break in the blood vessel. Part 2. Stage 2 roles of blood clotting is first to prevent the loss of blood and also helps to prevent the pathogen from entering into the blood. C. Hemophilia is a sex-linked blood disorder. The blood of people with hemophilia takes longer to clot. Figure 3.3 is a pedigree diagram showing the inheritance of hemophilia. So the allele for normal clotting time is represented by X capital H, and the allele for hemophilia is represented by X smaller H. Part 1. State the genotype of the people identified as PQR in figure 3.3. So P is this, which is female with normal clotting time, will show as X big H and X small H. Q is here, which is hemophilia, which is X smaller H Y. And R is for male and also has hemophilia, but doesn't have hemophilia, it just has normal clotting time, but has a Y chromosome, which X capital H and a Y. Okay, part 2. The couple S and T are expecting another child. State the probability and that the child will have hemophilia. So the couple S and T. S and T is the same as P and R. So use your... I've done something wrong in here. No wonder there's something weird. P and R. P and R. S and T same as P and R. Okay. I've done something wrong here, okay? But don't worry, let's do it again. So, P is XH and XH, and R is XH, Y. So, I will have XH, 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 Y, XH, XH, and XH, Y. So, this results that the one that has hemophilia is only the one with the lowercase H. So which is the only one, and you know that 3 out of 4 is normal clotting time and 125% or 0.25 has hemophilia. Part 3. Describe what is meant by the term sex-linked characteristics. So this is another definition question and you must memorize this. The gene is located on the sex chromosome where a particular characteristic is more common than another, usually in different sex. Okay. Question 4a. Yeast can respire aerobically and anaerobically. State the balanced chemical equation for aerobic respiration. So this is how it's gonna look like. Balance and a chemical equation. B. When yeast respire anaerobically, ethanol is produced. Ethanol is a type of sustainable resource that can be made from a wide range of crop plants. It can be used as biofuels. And table 4.1 will summarize some of the information from the crop plants that are useful to make biofuel. A country has a mean temperature range of 12 to 24 degrees, about room temperature, and the country has a mean annual rainfall of 1000 mm. Suggest and explain why which crop plant will be the most suitable to grow to produce biofuel in the country. And my answer will be sugar beet, because its rainfall is about 800 to 1200 and the optimum temperature is about 360 to 1000. Its optimum growth is at 18. So it grows under suitable temperature and also rainfall. Okay. C. Describe and explain how a reduced concentration of water vapor in the air would increase the movement of water through crop plants. So again, when the reduced concentration of water vapor in the air will cause transpiration rate to increase, because more water vapors is inside than the outside. Therefore, the water vapor will diffuse out of the stomata by diffusion, okay? This is the reason why reduced concentration of water vapor on the air will happen to be like this. D. Sugarcane is a crop plant that is usually grown from stem cuttings rather than from seeds. Describe the advantage of using cuttings rather than the seed to reproduce crop plants. So first thing, it helps to minimize the genetic variation. It provides that all the plants are uniform and also possess the same exact features. Okay? Question 5. Figure 5.1 shows the marine iguana Amblyrhynchus cristatus. A. Part 1. Marine iguanas are reptiles. The two features that are used to classify animals as reptiles. First one is dry scaly skins. Second one is soft eggs. Part 2. State two structures that are present in plant cells that are not present in the cells of reptiles. First one is cell wall and the second one is chloroplast. B. Marine iguanas feed on seaweed. Seaweed contains starch. State the names of two parts of the digestive system where starch is digested by enzymes. First one is small intestine and the second one is from the mouth. Part 2. Explain why the shape of an enzyme is important for digestion. So it is important to ensure the active site of the enzyme is complementary to the substrate so it can catalyze to form an enzyme-substrate complex so a product can be formed. Alright, that's pretty much it. C. There are many threats to species such as the marine iguana. Describe ways an endangered plant and animal species can be conserved. So this is a very, very free question. So what you can do is that I also listed a few examples in bullet point, but of course in your exam, you must write in full sentences. And I give things such as captive breeding programs, undergoing AI and IVF. AI means artificial insemination, and IVF is in vitro fertilization. And providing education and awareness, protect the habitats and reduce pollution, prevent introduced species, prevent hunting, monitor the population, protected areas such as national parks should be of course started, and also to do seed banks, alright, and store seeds for a longer period. Okay, question 6. Wetlands are important ecosystem. Researchers studied that the feeding relationship between the organism in an area of a coastal wetland. Figure 6.1 shows part of the food web that they studied. So complete table 6.1 by the name giving a name of one organism from the food web in figure 6.1 for each row. So the producer is the algae, which you can see it's from here, or the phytoplankton. The second one is the stone crab, which is the secondary consumer, which is first consumer, secondary consumer, first consumer, secondary consumer, and first consumer, and the secondary consumer. An animal that feeds at two trophic levels, which is the blenny or the spotted sandpiper. Okay. Alright, next question. B. The functioning of ecosystem relies on the cycling of nutrients. Figure 6.2 shows part of the nitrogen cycle. Part 1. State the name of process A in figure 6.2 and give the type of organism that converts ammonium ions to nitrate ions. A is actually nitrification, and the type of organism is by the nitrifying bacteria. Part 2. Describe how the nitrate ions used in process C enters the root of the plant. So the root hair will definitely absorb the nitrate ions by active transport across the membrane from a lower to higher concentration gradient by protein carrier. So this kind of question just link how is it absorbed and then active transport definition. Okay, then this is how you score your 3 marks. Part 3. State the name of the structure in the plant cell where process D occurs. Name of structure in process D. So process D is here where they make proteins. Making protein is from one kind of cell is called a ribosome. Alright. Part 4. State the process that occurs at B. This is from nitrogen gas in air to nitrogen ion. So this is from nitrogen fixation. C. A pyramid of numbers for the wetland ecosystem showed that there are very large numbers of organisms at the base of the pyramid and very few at the top. Explain why. So I've given also a list in bullet points. So first one is that there's energy loss between each trophic level and there's lesser energy for higher trophic level to support the larger organisms. And of course, the ways of energy loss is by either respiration or excretion. Okay? So that is all for this paper. Thank you so much for watching this video. All the best.